We control 80% of the consumer buying power.
This seems to be an unsourced claim that feminists use to intimidate companies into submitting to them. However, it does not hold up to mathematical scrutiny. According to US Census Bureau, there are 126 million US Americans in opposite sex relationships and 1.72 million US Americans in same-sex relationships. Of course, these numbers do not take into account polyamorous relationships, however that number is most certainly negligible. And the US population is 321 million. We will assume that there is as many men as women, which is roughly true, and the difference is negligible. This means that people in opposite sex relationships make up 39.4% of the population, and 60.6% is made up by singles and people in same-sex relationships. Unfortunately, I do not know the difference of the average earnings between men and women, and the relationship status distribution as a function of our wealth, so I'm using the medians and assume uniform distribution. As we all know, so I'm not going to bother citing it, it has been done to death, the median earnings for women is 77% of the median earnings for men. Feminists usually say that this is for the same job, but we all know that is on aggregate. On the screen you see the wealth distribution over the relevant mutually exclusive demographics. This gives us an equation for determining how much of the couple's money women in opposite sex relationships spend. This number comes out to be 187%. The only way for this number to be correct is if women or couples are disproportionately in serious debt, or if one of the excluded factors are significant, which probably is not the case. The most likely case is that this is just a lie. It could be the case that women spend 80% of the family's income. If that is the case, they only control 57.9% of the consumer buying power.